Hi, welcome to the Commercial Gas Engineer channel. Just a week in the life of a commercial gas engineer. First of all, this boiler is flashing up with L9. And also on the control panel, we had a low limit alarm on. It is no longer on up here because we sorted it out. The low limit heating alarm is on because the heating pumps have been turned off for the summer. But as for the hot water, the alarm was on, but I managed to solve that pretty soon. Let me show you how. So I saw the pumps. For some reason, one of the heating pumps were still on, so I shut that off. And then I went over here. I've got my two hot water service pumps to the block of flats, and the hot water temperature was only at 30 Celsius. So I carried out some checks that when I turned the boiler on, two boilers that were working out of three. Number one had been isolated, but boiler two and three, what had happened is they were kettling when I turned them on. So I wanted to know why. So I went to the pumps, the pump on the right, the pump over here. Here's the temperature after getting it to work. So when I looked at the pump, obviously opened up the vent point and had a look to see if it was rotating, but it had completely ceased. So here you have it. This is where, as the temperatures began to rise, this is the heat inside, but that one isn't so important. It's more the hot water that we want to sort out. And then here's the pump that had ceased. And then there's a pump on the left. So the gate valve on the pump on the left was isolated. So I opened it up. But before opening it up, I turned the pump on and carried out some tests. I didn't realize they were isolated. Let me show you my findings. This is me checking the amps that the pump was pulling before I opened up the valve, before realizing the valve was isolated. 0.65 on speed 3, 0.59 on speed 2, and 0.52 on speed 1. So quite consistent readings there on the ampage. Once I realized that the gate valve was isolated and opened it, this is the readings that I got. I got 1.11 on speed 3, 1.02 on speed 2, and 0.73 on speed 1. And then the pump began to circulate and get the heat away from the boilers, and the boilers stopped kettling and locking out with L9 faults. And then next was working on a Hamworthy, one of the ones that have a damper for high and low fire. This is a look inside, so I took a picture inside the flue to look at the position of the damper in high and low. So this is the part for high and this is the part for low. So when the boiler goes into high and low fire, ideally you want them in a vertical position when it's in high fire. And you want the other damper in vertical when it's in low fire, but it's okay if the outer is horizontal in low fire. I was having a problem with the boiler going into high fire, and that was because the damper wasn't moving over fully. So here is an image of the shaft, and had to put a mark on it so that had a good indication of what was happening inside on the damper motor. So lined up both high and low and then rotated it accordingly. Rotated and had a look inside to see when it should be off, the position of both outer and inner shaft for low and high fire. So this is the position of one of the units when it was in high fire. It didn't cut out, it stayed in high fire, but as you can see, the high fire damper was perfect, but the low fire wasn't. But it didn't stop the model from working. The flue exhaust still managed to escape. But ideally, you want them to both be completely vertical. Inside here, you can see the PCB, and on the main PCB, you've got the high fire, as you can see here. You've got the high fire proven switch, and on the left, you've got the low fire. You've got CN1 and then CN2. So the power out, the brown going to the damper, is meant to be standard 230, and then when it is satisfied and it is and then coming back, you have the black that would be the satisfied connection once the damper's in the correct position, and then the boiler would go into high fire, and then you've also got the same in a low fire. You can buy plugs for these, for them to be bypassed in certain special circumstances. So that's what these are for. You can carry out tests to make sure that the damper is sending the correct signal and so on back. And here is another picture of the damper motor in action. And there's another picture of it as well. There's one in front and one behind. And then in my lunch breaks, I have been really enjoying watching a new playlist I created. You can find it. It's called Commercial Gas Engineer Videos from Various Channels. I have managed to find some really good videos in plant rooms throughout the world, and there's some really good videos. Please check it out. I think it would help you. It depends how thirsty you are for more knowledge or to grow in your trade. But there has been some really good stuff. I've got some stuff from the US as well. Some of the principles are still the same in control panels and so on. So check those out. What else do we have in here? There's also plant room tours and so on that you can see. Building service videos, not just about heating and gas, but also bits about air conditioning. You've got various ways of how people work in here. You've got all oil burners, and you've got some videos of people making adjustments, different types of adjustments that they like to make on their burners. Quite good. Some really good videos. So do check them out. Let me know if you have any that you'd like to recommend as well. Also, people showing you how to test LEMO valves. So if you're not familiar with testing like Y and 24 volts and 0 volts and so on, and checking relays, check out some of these videos. They are very good. Steam as well. So I'm more going into industrial heating. So have a look. Some people are really good at teaching electrics. So please send me any recommendations as well of any videos that you have seen, any channels, and I'll add them to this playlist. All right, thank you for joining me. Until next time. Bye, bye, bye.